Do you want to host a WordPress site, but a VPS is just too much or just too expensive? Luckily, there's shared hosting that brings the prices way down. I will be showing you a deal that Hostinger has for you on this video. Now, what I'm going to be covering on this video is I'm gonna connect a Cloudflare domain that I have over there via DNS to host it on Hostinger to show you how easy it actually is to install a WordPress site, bringing it from Cloudflare. So, let's go jump over to my dashboard to check out the prices and how to actually connect from Cloudflare to Hostinger. Let's go jump over there. All right, before we jump into the shared hosting offer that they have now, I want to show you that they have other hosting systems. For example, they have cloud hosting, WordPress hosting, cPanel hosting, VPS hosting, Minecraft hosting, CyberPanel VPS hosting, and all of that is available on Hostinger. So let's stick into shared hosting on this video. So they have three plans available. One is a single, premium, and business. Single plan is meant for one single website. In my opinion, I don't recommend this because it's just too limited. I would recommend jumping to premium shared hosting, even if you're all going to host one plan. Why? You have the flexibility to grow with 100 websites. You get more storage, more power, and weekly backups, and just more things that you would get than in the single shared hosting. If you need daily backups, CDN, more storage, jump into the business shared hosting. So those are the plans that are available. Now, there's a discount going on right now. You can view it there, but there's an additional discount using a coupon code. Let me show you how it actually works. So if we select the premium shared hosting, let's select that. To get the best price, you're locked in with 12 months or 48 months. You can see that we have a great price on those two. Let's stick with the 48 months, which is 4 years. To get an additional discount from this total, well, let's just have a coupon code, and we're gonna add SaaS Master. We're gonna add, remember, it's $124.32. Let me apply the coupon, and it turns out you're only going to pay $150.20 for 4 years of hosting. So you're gonna forget about having to pay every single month or every year. You're locked in for 48 months, all right? Okay, enough said about that. Let's go jump into our hPanel right here, which what we're gonna do is we're gonna connect our DNS from Cloudflare to add a website here. What are we gonna do? Well, this is our IP address for this shared hosting. We're gonna need that to connect it with Cloudflare, okay? So let's go into add a new site, okay? And we're gonna add the domain. In this case, we're gonna say Hostinger test. SaaSmaster.net. All right. So I already own SaaSmaster.net and it's connected on Cloudflare, but nothing is hosted there. So I want to use my Hostinger shared hosting to connect it here and install WordPress on it. Okay. So let's go into my Cloudflare. This is my SaaSmaster domain. We're going to go into DNS and we're going to add a record. In this case, we're going to add in a record. And we're gonna name it our site that we're going to use. This is going to be a subdomain. So we're gonna say, what do we call it? Hostinger test, all right. Hostinger test, okay, there we go. You can see how it's looking right here. Hostinger test.saasmaster.net. And the IP is the one that we're gonna add from our hosting provider. That's Hostinger shared account. Let's remove the SSL for now so it's quicker to propagate. Okay, now we have it connected. So let's go back into our site. Let me input the password from my Hostinger account. There we go, it's been added. Here it is, hostingertest.saasmaster.net. I can go ahead and manage it. Let me not save that. Okay, now I am on this site, all right? So what I'm going to do is I am going to install WordPress, all right? So let's go ahead and install WordPress. Let's install it for WordPress. If you want to use the tech WordPress, that means that you use the file manager and you imported the files there. But in this case, nothing is installed. So we're going to install our own WordPress site. So what we're gonna do is click install, all right? And now we're gonna choose where we want to install it. If you need to enter it on a subfolder, use this. If not, leave it blank because we want our website here. Hostingertest.saasmaster.net. That's going to be the link that's going to open up our WordPress site. But if we needed to install it on a subcategory, input something there. Okay, so let me add a password that I'm going to use for this. So add that password title, it's just test site. the language that I want to install it in. In this case, I'll just keep it in English. The email for the admin, create a database, create a new one, a database password. Again, I just input a password for this. And it's going to install the required disk spaces that it's going to use, the PHP version, which is 8.0, minimum MySQL version 5. And do you want it to update only minor versions? So that way, how would you say, you're protecting yourself from not updating on huge versions because it might break your site. Or you could just turn it off and you go ahead and update it manually. I would recommend that. Unless you don't know much about it, just keep it update only minor versions. So let's go ahead and install. All right, our WordPress site has just been installed on Hostinger. Let's go ahead and preview it. If we click on preview my site, you're gonna view the front end of your site. Obviously there's nothing going on. There's no themes or anything installed. This is just a plain WordPress site. But if we want to jump into the admin side of our WordPress site, we can click on it right here. Also, if you forget your username and password to log into your WordPress site, you can do it through here. Like I just click on that button, it opens up the admin panel. Here we can obviously edit our site. We can add our plugins, our themes, and our pages, posts, and everything that you want to do for WordPress. Super easy and fast to install, okay? So you saw how easy that was. Now we have several options available. In this case, we have enabled Lightspeed, which is a cache plugin. I really recommend that you keep it on if you want to install an SSL certificate, if you want to connect to Cloudflare with the setup here. The PHP version is 8.0. If you want to lower the version, just in case there's a confliction with another theme or plugin, you can do so in the main dashboard, okay? WordPress version, it's the latest one. Site installs. So if you want to install another WordPress site, just click on it there. We have the plugins that are available. These are installed because they could be useful. You can remove them here or remove them on your WordPress site. So you can do it through there, right? Some learning tutorials here if you want to check them out. Now, what else can we do? Let's go into our dashboard, okay? And we can view, for example, if you want to upgrade your account, you can do so through here. Let me show you, you can create email accounts. Obviously, you will have to connect the settings via DNS. If you're using a host, if you're using a domain outside of Hostinger. So like I did right now, we'd have to add those DNS settings for the email accounts to work. If you want to add subdomains, park domains, add websites, redirects, Cloudflare's. If you want to use an auto installer, import a website, migrate website, error pages, SEO toolkit that's available, file manager. So let's go ahead and check that out because that's important. If you need to edit a file inside of that installation, we're able to do so through here, or unless you want to use the FFTP. Let's click on it twice, and here's our files for this site. Here's all the files that we need in case we want to edit those, all right? There's the backups, FTP accounts, if you need to create one. In case you don't want to use the file manager, create an FTP account and connect through there. If you need to tweak the databases, PHP admin, let me show you this right here. You need to edit that. All right, let's go there. Remote MySQL, DNS zone editor. So again, if you're connecting through here and using this DNS editor, you can do so through here. PHP configuration, like I mentioned before, if you need to lower the version, you can do so through here. Once you do so, it will update and it'll change the PHP version. I recommend you use the latest one because obviously there's no security problems because they're up to date. It could be hackable later on if you use a version that's in the past, okay? So I recommend use the latest one unless you have a conflict with another theme or plugin, okay? Back to our dashboard. If you need to set up cron jobs for manual crons, you can do so there. SSH access, PHP info, cache manager, Git, SSL, and other type of things that you might need for your hosting service, all right? So you can see how easy it was to connect our domain that we have on Cloudflare to host on Hostinger so we can have a live WordPress site so our clients can view it. Super easy and fast, plus the price is really great. Well, I thank y'all for watching. My name is George, this is SaaS Master, and I'll see you guys later.